All right, Adam, my man, this one is for you. I know you've got a seminar coming up this weekend and you wanted to know a few investor tactics. So I created this video just for you and to help other investors as well, kind of share my story and what I do when it comes to strategically closing mobile home parks. So number one, the clock starts once you have your diligence items from the seller. So there's a couple different ways to do this. Number one is you simply get the park under contract and the clock starts. You're off to the races. Or number two, what we like to do is once you get the park under contract, you add it to the contract where say you give and reach out to me, tony@parkplaceedu.com if you want it, but there's a seller due diligence item request checklist. So what this allows you to do is not only get the park under contract, but say you've got 45 days of closing once the seller provides all information to you. So that, my man, is tactic number one. Okay, tactic number two, and we're gonna delve into this a bit. 82% of our parks have been closed through owner carry, owner financing. So what you wanna do the day you've got the park under contract, you wanna start reaching out to banks. You know, say the park is only 65% occupied. What you're doing is you're kind of slowly setting the table if maybe you do an owner carry deal as opposed to bank financing. So say you reach out to two or three local banks and they don't want nothing to do with the park because it's 60% occupied. They're bad rent collections, etc., etc. So what you're going to do is you're slowly going to reach out to the seller and let them know, hey, seller, you know, I'm committed to the deal. I want to get this deal closed, but this bank's not willing to look at the park. So I've got some additional documentation, 8 reasons why the seller should carry and why you're serving the seller as well. Okay, buy yourself more time. So here's what I do is every single deal that I've ever completed, I've done through investors and with investors and find the best way that you can serve your investors as well. So here's one way to buy yourself some more time. On our first deal, let's just say that I had it under contract and the seller wanted $100,000 down payment. Now, maybe at the time I only had 25 grand and I'm bringing on investors and say I get to 50 grand, I'm at 60 grand. I know I'm committed to the park, but I don't have enough capital. So what you want to do is reach out to the seller, let them know that, hey, here's one option is let your earnest money go hard, meaning you're fully committed, you're gonna get the deal closed, due diligence is checking out, but you just need some more time to raise some more capital from investors. So there is one more tactic. All right, here's another one is, I talk to investors all the time, every single day, and I love the heck out of you guys. And just keep reaching out to me. If you want me to knock out videos, this is what I'm here for. 2018, our own boot camp, so we're gonna absolutely crush it, and I'm so excited about that. But what you don't wanna do is, say you've got closing set up on August 1st. Now, 99 out of 100 times, literally something happens. The title work doesn't go through, the paperwork on the housing, or the seller can't make it, something comes up. So many times there's delays in the closing, be it the commitment work. So there's always items, there's probably 20 or 30 moving pieces. So what you don't wanna do is go fly out of state and you know say you're set for closing on Monday and you don't close till Thursday. So what we do is we simply set up remote closings. Again, I've been to 1 of 16 closings on our deals. And that was a pain in the ass because I had to deal with the seller and he's a mean ass old man. So, but anyways, we just set it up to where we communicate with the title company. We're communicating with the broker, the seller, and they'll overnight the documents to us and we essentially do it that way. All right, this is a good one right here. All right, so I've got a total of 7 for you. I'm committed and again, here to serve. So let the seller be the bad guy. Here's what I mean is, say you got a park under contract and you're getting ready to close here in the next few days. Say the lot rents are 200 bucks currently and, or let me back up. Say you're ready to close like in 2 or 3 weeks, I should say, or even a month. Say the lot rents are 100, 150 bucks below market. So what you wanna do is, have the seller be the bad guy. They're selling the park. They're gonna walk away with some cash. And here's what I'm referring to is bump up the lot rents. Have the seller do it, though. Have that negotiated in the contract as well, where the seller sends the residents a letter that the rent increases are going to be taking place as of, you know, maybe September 1st. So here you just bumped up the lot rent, increased your NOI, and the seller's the bad guy. So you come in and you're the new owner. And you know what? This is what the lot rents are. Okay, so be mindful of startup costs. This is a really big one. So I'm going to give you two separate examples here. Number one is our first park that we bought, the startup costs for water, sewer, trash, electric, literally was, I'm just guessing here, but it was probably about $150, $200 between our mobile home park license fee. And then you take another park completely across the country in a different area, a different city, a different county, the startup costs were over $10,000. So one thing that you want to do is you want to be mindful of what the startup costs are. As you get the park under contract, you're performing due diligence, call the water company, call the sewer, the trash company, the electric, figure out what the startup costs are going to be, because sometimes they hit out-of-state investors a bit harder. All right, so and this kind of segues into, as our last tactic, this segues into bringing on partners and raising capital. This has happened to us before, and it's a bad position to be in, and I don't want that to happen to you. So once you know your startup costs, once you know the all-in costs, maybe you do a deal acquisition fee, maybe you build out a couple fees as well if you're raising capital. I'll be teaching that this year as well. A bit unconventional, but I'm going to share how I did it, how I went from 25 grand to, you know, $10-20 million worth of assets in 23 months. So if you're interested, send me an email, tony@parkplaceedu.com, titled Bootcamp. So I only have a few more students than our first one that I've got openings for, but I'm probably going to do about two this year. I don't want to do too much. I'm about family and just living in the moment, but I want to help 100 investors take down deals this year. So, okay, raise 125% capital. Here's the thing is you're either doing this on your own or you're doing it with investors. And if you're doing it with investors, say you've got three or four investors in the deal, well, things happen. People have emergencies. What I don't want you to do is I don't want you to get to be a week before closing and one investor in emergency happens and backs out. So that's not a good position to be in. So what you do is say your park is funded with investors and you're good on capital, you don't need any more capital. You want to still have that investor package and send that to other investors. Let them know, hey guys, this is the deal that we're just getting ready to close on right now. And if this is something that you're interested in, you know, definitely let me know. And hopefully if you've done it right, you've got a home run park, 15 to 20% cap, you know, maybe 12% cap. I don't know, depending on where you're investing. But once you kind of perk their interest, and in the event that somebody does back out, then reach out to them and find a way to serve them. So, all right, this is gonna cover it. But what I wanted to do is I just wanna knock out a quick bonus for you right now. As again, you're going to a seminar. So one of the things is as you network, as you get with other fellow investors, here's the thing, and this is a huge secret, and I want everybody to know this is, number one, it comes down to two roads, and no road's the right road or the wrong road. So it depends on where you're at, what season in life, as Jim Rohn calls it. So sometimes it's great to invest in OPD or other people's deals, or sometimes it's great to invest in your own deals. So I personally like having control of my capital. And again, sometimes it's great to invest in other people's deals, but there's something about creating your own deals. My thing is, do I want to fit into somebody else's retirement, or do I want to create my own retirement? So what I want you to do is, and everybody that's listening, again, I honor you and I congratulate you for listening as well, is when you're networking, any real estate event, in any marketing event, be intentional. And here's what I mean is, introduce yourself, create relationships. So let's just say that you find a park. Well, go have dinner with a few other people, go have coffee with them, and you know, just connect with them intentionally. Have your business cards, and say you find a deal, well, guess what? they're already sold on the niche, on the sector. So the thing is you're just simply a connector. Maybe you meet some great investors. And I met investors every time I go to local networking events and just kind of local marketing. So, all right, that's gonna cover it for this one. If you like the video, subscribe to my channel. I'm committed to knocking out everything that I possibly can this year and sharing all of it, just putting all out on the table. So, all right, have a great one. Have a great event, my man. And I will talk to you guys soon.